Tonight on 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdown, our reigning champion, it's Jon Richardson. Ready for the rematch, it's Sean Locke. In Dictionary Corner, he's vowel-mouthed, it's David O'Doherty. My word, it's Susie Dent. She's a math magician, it's Rachel Riley. Now, welcome your host, Jimmy Carr.
Hello, and welcome to 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdown, a show all about letters, numbers, and conundrums. Did you know, according to lexicographers, 40 is the only number that, when written down, has all its letters in alphabetical order? Interestingly, 40 is also how old most lexicographers are before they see a naked lady. The word crap comes from the last name of the person that invented the toilet, Thomas Crapper, narrowly beating designs by Thomas Schitter and Thomas, I'd leave that 10 minutes if I were you. Palindromes are words or phrases that read the same in both directions. My favourite palindromes that I've ever come across are tit and boob. Right, let's get started. OK, let's meet tonight's players. First up, it's our Cats Countdown reigning champion, Jon Richardson. You can see Jon regularly in 8 out of 10 Cats, Stand Up for the Week and the Meals for One section of his local supermarket. In 1998, chess player Garry Kasparov was beaten by supercomputer Deep Blue. But later this year, Jon will seek to prove that there are still some tasks beyond modern technology when he takes on the computer at Match.com. And up against Jon is Sean Locke. Laid-back Sean is best described as happy-go-fuck-yourself. Sean never fails to see the funny side of life. It doesn't matter whether he's shouting at a child or drop-kicking a kitten, you always see him laughing. Remind me, what happened last time you played?
Through some weird sort of anomaly of scoring, Jon went home with a teapot.
An anomaly of scoring?
Swatsy, planet head here. One. That's what happened.
Your face. We got the same train back, and I had my teapot, but I thought I'd lost my... I really wanted my nameplate for my desk.
Yeah, you did.
And I thought I'd lost it on the train. And I was on the train, oh, I think I've lost my... And your face really said, you are a penis. No support. Now, oh, that's a shame, Jon. That would have been a really good memento to have. You just said, it's just your name written on a piece of paper.
He's right, though.
Well, I just hope for John's sake he doesn't win tonight, because then he'd have more teapots than friends.
Oh! The tension, it's a grudge match.
To be honest, as a form of humiliation, it's all right for you, you won. It's awful. I'd rather do a Bush Tucker trial. There's a certain dignity in eating a kangaroo's bollock, which you don't get from losing at spelling quizzes.
So do you feel extra pressure? Because we're all expecting you to win by some margin today.
No, they're not expecting that.
Well, I mean, what are you talking about? Everyone is expecting Jon
to win. It's horrible. I hope I lose. The pressure's... I can't get on a train. People are shouting letters at me. It's horrible. See how you cope with the pressure.
I don't think it'd be a problem. No, but the jump is just jumbled up. I look at the... When the letters come up, it just doesn't mean... I just don't see anything. It's like a Dutch number plate.
What about that one? I mean, that one's easy. Start with that one.
Out, I've got there.
I've got another word.
Yeah.
OK, over in Dictionary Corner today, it's David O'Doherty.
Send out the funny text. Hey, we're all wearing novelty jumpers on Countdown. It's going to be hilarious, David. You all wear your fancy suits and I'm left here looking pretty sweet, actually.
Very nice. As an Irishman, David is probably more familiar with the Irish version of this show. County Down. With his quirky, unkept appearance, David O'Doherty resembles a top university professor who's fallen on hard times, turned to alcohol, and gone to live in a hedge. Very nice to have you here, David, is what I meant to say.
It's a pleasure.
Yeah, it's fun, right?
It's one of my top two favourite shows on Channel 4. After Grand Designs. Here's how much I love Grand Designs, dressed up as Kevin MacLeod for Halloween. And he doesn't really have a look, so it's just a T-shirt with a leather jacket. And when people didn't know who I was, to give them a clue, I'd just be mildly critical of their interior decoration. I mean, I really like what you tried to do here, and it very nearly worked.
And with David is, of course, Susie Dent. Susie likes nothing more than taking a dictionary to bed and having a good flick. Just like your mum with 50 Shades of Grey. And in charge of numbers, it's Rachel Riley. Rachel Riley is the sexiest mathematician in the world, which sounds impressive until you find out number two is Stephen Hawking. Rachel Riley is as clever as she is beautiful, but then again, so is Sean Locke. OK, let's get ready to count down. Time for the first game. John, you get the first pick of the letters.
I'll have a consonant, please.
Thank you, John.
You
start
sure?
with...
You sure?
A good one. R.
I don't think a consonant's a good idea, John.
We get rid of the R.
Do whatever you want.
I'm really easily led.
Oh!
Done.
Chaos already. Brilliant.
There'll be people, Countdown fans, watching that going, you can't do that!
Come on, pick your
letters. I'm going to have a consonant.
Thank you, John. M.
Oh, much better.
That's better. That's better.
And another one, please.
Can't G.
Say that and not sound like a dick. And another one, please.
M.
Let's bang another one out.
M.
Do you write them all down?
I would just write the last one, Sean, and see how you get on.
How you doing it?
I'll have a vowel, please.
Oh, I've written two N's down.
Someone gasped when I said vowel, then. yeah, let's shit another vowel in there.
E.
And another one, please.
A.
And another consonant, please.
F.
And another vowel, please.
And the last one. O.
Right, well, for the first time today, here's the countdown clock. Right, how many letters, John?
Just a five.
Sean?
I haven't finished yet.
Sean?
What?
How many you got?
What, how many have I got?
Yeah.
Oh, I've got to count them up now, Jesus.
I'll give you a clue, you won't need the other hand.
One, two, three, four, five, six.
Six? Yeah. John, what have you got?
But it is using my free letter that I've played.
Have you played your joker?
Yes, I have a letter I use. It's like an O. It's got a line through it and a smiley face. I call it free letter and it counts as anything. All right, four.
Four, Sean, what have you got?
Foog.
How are you spelling foog in the traditional manner?
F-double-O-G.
Foog.
As in to Carter N.
No, as in if I'm going to foog something.
You're using this in the sense of you're fooging this right up.
Yeah.
Yeah, which is very accurate.
Well, traditionally, a fooger would have fooged things, yes, definitely. A fooger would have travelled round the village and announcing, have you got anything to foog? And he would bring it out, and they go, oh, the fooger's here, and he would foog it.
John?
I've got foog, I've just put an extra R in it. I've got gnome.
Gnome. That's it.
David, did you do any better than gnome?
Yeah, I've got a ex-mango. There used to be a mango, but now it's just a rotting pile of flies and mold. Ex-mango.
Susie, what could they have had?
I'm afraid I've only got fives too. Mange, not very nice. Fango, which is mud from thermal springs in Italy.
So just fives was all that was possible.
Yeah,
you did as
fives.
Well as could be expected.
Thank you. I've heard
not
that so
much.
Often. That really is the best we could have hoped for you, John. Well done.
So at the end of that, John is in the lead with 5 points.
Well done, John.
Well done. OK. OK, Sean, your turn to pick the letters.
A vowel, please.
Thank you, Sean.
That's right.
E.
Another vowel, please.
I.
Another vowel, please. Another vowel, please.
Oh, please let it be an O.
I'll have to go for another vowel, please.
Oh.
E-I-E-I-A.
I have a consonant, please.
S.
S. And another consonant.
N.
I bash out a couple more, will you, darling?
B and
B.
H.
Thank you.
And your time starts now. Sean, how many letters?
Five.
Five, John?
Seven, I think.
Seven. Sean, what's your five?
Sheen.
What's your seven, John?
Banshee.
Brilliant.
Whoa.
Oh.
It's a noise I hear a lot in the bedroom. She screamed like a...
As you peered at the window.
David, could they have done any better than Banshee?
I got a three. Oh, is this the biggest?
Yeah, we got some more sevens. High knees, which John also might see a lot in the bedrooms. Those are people's buttocks, and they might be wearing beanie hats. But seven was the tops. Again, well done. It's...
OK, Sean has no points, and John has 12 points. On to our first numbers round. OK, John, go ahead and pick your numbers.
Can I have two big ones and four small ones, please?
You can, thank you, John. Two from the top and four little numbers. And for the first numbers game, they are 1, 5, 6, 10, and the large two, 25 and 50. And your target... Oh, dear. Nah. Sean might get this one, 400.
OK, I'm just going to see how many cream crackers I can eat. Let's start the clock now.
You've got to put the pressure on me now.
I can't do it.
model what?
I think I've got it. I got 6 times 50 is 300.
6 times 50, 300.
5 no, minus right. 1 is 4.
Okay.
Times yeah. 25 is 100.
Yay!
400. I was there. I didn't get it till like the clock went doo doo doo.
Is that why you shouted and went?
Well done.
I did 25 minus 10 minus 6 minus 1.
Ah, the old easy
25
way.
25 minus 10 minus 6 minus 1 is 8.
Times 50.
Times 50, 400. Well done. Yeah.
OK, time to go across to Dictionary Corner. David, what have you got for us?
Well, I am a big fan of Countdown, and I just feel the time is right now, no disrespect, to bring it to another level. I'm not talking about improving it. I just mean making it better. And the certain aspects of the show have been the same for a long time. The music while the thing goes round.
Oh, yeah,
It's, and I just think we could do something with that using my favourite instrument from 1986. And I just think with this, take it up a notch, maybe with maybe just a bit more tension. You know what I mean? Ooh. Get a bit more mayhem going, the adrenaline rush. Maybe do something with the lights, yeah? Put some explosions in. The ice sheets are melting. Kids are overeating. Ah! The tigers are crying. The oceans are drying. So quick, get numbers and letters and find out who's better before we all die. Wait.
OK, he scores at the end of the first part. Our Sean has 10 points, John has 22. And here's your teaser. The words are arse muff, and the clue is they'll keep you warm on a winter's day. That's arse muff. They'll keep you warm on a winter's day. See you after the break. Welcome back to Ed Out of Ten Cats Does Countdown. The answer to the teaser, the words were arse muff, and the clue was, they'll keep you warm on a winter's day. It was, of course, earmuffs. So, John, you're in the lead. Your pick of the letters.
I will have a consonant, please, Rachel.
Thank you, John. P.
And another one, please.
W.
And a vowel, please.
E.
And another consonant, please.
Q.
Bollocks.
And another vowel, please.
O.
And another consonant, please.
R.
And another vowel, please.
U.
These are terrible letters.
And another consonant, please.
D.
And another consonant. Oh, I thought I got round it. Let's have another vowel.
The last one, A. Good choice.
Thanks,
and
mate.
Here is the countdown clock. John, how many letters?
Six.
Six. Sean?
If I said five, that would be about right. That would be pretty close to how many I've got.
OK, what's the word, Sean?
It's five.
Go on, what's the word?
Oh, what's the word?
Yeah, what you got?
Oh, I see, right, I see. A prude.
Prude?
Yeah.
Prude, OK. John?
Poured. As in, like, a liquid.
David?
I another seven here. That's it's nothing to do with me. And it is opaquer.
Opaquer.
Yes.
Which means, of course...
More opaque.
More... Yes. Yes, I imagine it does. If anything, you've made that clearer.
Good.
OK, so the scores now. John has 28 and Sean has 10 still.
What are you going to do?
Time for the numbers again. Sean, your turn to pick. Now, Sean had a bit of trouble with the numbers last time, so I thought I'd change it up a little bit and give him a bit of help. For this round only, Sean will be allowed to play with a teammate, and that teammate will be Rachel Riley.
Oh.
Yeah. Rachel, if you could go over there and join Sean.
Well, thank
you. Rachel.
Now, obviously, taking numbers? Rachel's place at the numbers board, please welcome mathematical genius Joe Wilkinson. So, Joe, you any good at maths?
Yeah. Rachel's not the only stun who can add up.
OK, Sean, pick the numbers.
Four large, please, Joe.
Hey?
Four large runs and a packet of crisps.
Right, you are, Sean.
That's what
and
I look
one
like.
From the bottom.
Not quite what you look like.
Am I allowed to do... How many numbers are allowed to pick?
We want six.
All right, six. All right. And one from some other... Yeah. The other bit. Don't look at them. That's cheating. I imagine, Joe, you get done for shoplifting a lot.
Ten.
Ten.
Three.
Three.
100.
100.
50.
50.
Don't know what that is. that one. 75.
OK, and they're going for?
Fuck that.
That's too easy.
Yeah, we can't have one, so that's just too easy.
Oh, yeah. Yes.
OK, your time starts now.
Is 300. So we're halfway there. Times 50.
Ah!
150. Minus 100. That's 650.
So, John, what'd you get?
675.
Sean, what did you get?
675.
Rachel?
I got it. 676.
We got it.
We got it. We got it.
Let's see if we did it the same way.
Yeah, maybe, Rachel, you can tell us how you did it in a second. Joe, okay. Could you tell me how it should be done?
Oh, ladies first, go on. All right, let's say, oh, I feel sick. you got, your 100. plus, 10. 110. The 50. And then it's 7. And then ish.
Did you do it in the same way?
Slightly different.
Go on, how did you do it?
You used a 3, didn't you? That's why I went, yeah.
I said 75 minus 25.
Is
50.
Correct.
100 divided by 50.
Is 2.
Yes. 50 adds 2.
Yeah. Just similar.
And then 10 plus 3 is 13. And 13 times 52 is 676.
Whoa. Yeah.
I'm back. Hi, Sean.
I'm back.
Can I keep the pen?
If you promise not to sniff it.
Keep it, then.
This is Joe Wilkinson. Thank
Thanks,
you very
Rachel.
Much indeed. Round of applause for Joe.
Sean is on 20 and John is on 28. And here is your teaser. The words are piss, hole, and the clue is you'll need to spray and rub repeatedly. That's piss, hole, you'll need to spray and rub repeatedly. See you after the break. Welcome back to 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdown. The answer to your teaser, the words were piss hole, and the clue was you'll need to spray and rub repeatedly. And the answer is polishes. Here's another fun Countdown fact. The youngest ever winner of Countdown was just 14, and that's a good example of how you can be a winner and a loser at the same time. OK, let's mix things up a little bit now. I'm going to give both contestants some help in the form of a teammate who is a Countdown expert. Can you both pick a ball from this bag?
Okay. I've fallen for this before.
OK, this will determine your teammate, so just pick a ball. Yep. All right, lovely.
I've got a red ball.
You want to see someone about
that? That's Coventry.
Play Leeds United and we'll lose.
Well, Sean, you've got the red ball. And that means you'll be playing with Britain's brainiest footballer and former Countdown winner, Clark Carlisle.
Oh. Thank you.
So, John, you picked the yellow ball. That means you'll be playing with renowned maths expert, Joe Wilkinson. Right, gentlemen. Well, let's find out a little bit about Clark. Clark is widely recognised as Britain's brainiest footballer, which is, let's face it, a bit like being Britain's most sexually active stamp collector. Sorry, John, no offence. Joe Wilkinson plays the creepy next-door neighbour in the BBC sitcom Him and Her, and he's been getting into character for the last 32 years. Very nice to have you here. So, Clark, you won twice.
Yes.
And then you lost to... Who did you lose to?
A gentleman. I can't remember his name.
Oh, you say that. It haunts you.
It does. I blew a 21-point lead, which is unheard of, isn't it, really, in Countdown?
Joe, are you feeling confident?
Yep. Yes. Yes.
Yes. Are you better on the numbers or the letters?
I can count to well over 1,000 before I black out.
I've just noticed your mug.
Oh, yeah, it's good luck, you know, which we, you know, we swap stuff, you know. OK, Susie, if... life-size cut out of myself. She gave me this shit.
So, Sean, your turn to pick the letters.
OK. Do you do it one at a time? I'll go first.
Oh, let's.
I'll have a vowel, please.
Thank you, Sean. E.
E. No, you next.
Oh, consonant.
Britain's cleverest footballer.
A consonant, please,
thanks,
Rachel.
Clark. P.
In your own time, you two.
A vowel, please.
U.
Consonant, please.
C.
And I'll have another consonant, please.
Z.
And another one, please.
D.
D.
Dear.
And a vowel, please.
O.
Consonant, please.
T.
And a vowel.
And the last one. E.
Ooh. OK, and your time starts now. Right, what have you got? John?
Six.
Okay, Joe?
I've got a multicoloured pen. I spent most of the time choosing the colour. So I've got four.
Four?
Yeah, but I chose a colour, so.
Okay, a little victories. Sean, what have you got?
Four. Yeah.
And Clark?
And a six here as well.
Let's hear your six, Clark.
Pouted.
That's what I got.
Well, that's what you've got. Can we do the thing where you show them the bit of paper so we know that you haven't cheated?
No, that doesn't say pouted.
She's prompted. There's no N in there, John. Yeah, he had pouted. All right, give it to you.
OK, all right, so you both got pouted. Just out of interest, what was your four-letter word?
Paid.
Sean, what did you get?
Zeep.
Zeep meaning?
It's a Spanish. It's like a fastening on trousers. It's a Spanish word. We use it a lot. Thank you.
David, could they have done any better?
Toupee is there, but that is the same number of letters, but it takes longer to say.
Toupee.
And it has an accent.
At the end of that round, John's team have 34 points, Sean's team have got 26. Yeah. On to our next numbers round. John and Joe, you're to pick the numbers.
OK. I didn't think you could look any funnier. It's possible. It's an incredible achievement.
John and Joe, go ahead and pick your numbers.
Go on, mate. Knock yourself out, please.
Four little ones and a two big ones.
Oh. I can do that.
Please, please.
Two large ones, four small ones coming up for you. And for this round, the four small ones are 3, 6, 8, and another 3, and the large ones 50 and 75. And the target, 396.
Oh, Christ, didn't write them down.
OK, I'm going to try and do 10 press-ups. So the target was 396. John and Joe, did you get it?
I might have got 398, but
I think I've got yeah, say yeah.
Clark?
I got 397.
Sean, did you get it?
Yeah.
Go on, tell us how you got it.
So the three.
Three, yeah.
And then you've got the seven.
Which seven?
You add the five to the seven.
Where's the
five? What seven, Sean?
The 75. That gives you 12. Take three off that, that's 9. So that gives you 3 and 9.
Oh, you should have been watching,
and
Sean.
And then you use your 6. Yeah. 396.
OK, Clark.
8 by 50 is 400. And take a 3 off. Right.
8 by 50, 400.
Yeah,
400,
and that's one away. 397.
I could not make
the four. Deirdre Barlow, I reckon she's got it.
Deirdre Barlow, what have you got?
75 plus 50.
75 plus 50 is 125.
Times 3. Yeah.
You could have got it like that, but not like this. It's 375.
We'll see. Plus 8, plus 6, plus 3. So, it's near enough, isn't it?
8 is 17, and that's 392.
Yeah. Oh, it's 306.
So, can it be done?
Yeah, a couple of ways. You could have said 50 times 8 is 400. 75 minus 3, 72. Divided by the other 3 is 24. Divided by the 6 is 4. And take it off.
OK, time for a bit more from Dictionary Corner. David, what have you got for us?
I feel what Countdown needs is a sort of Simon Cowell-type figure who's not afraid to be a bit, you know... Like, you guys are good, but you could be... Like, look what you're dealing with here. Yeah. You could be a lot more sass. And I have... I've got some classic Countdown sass lines. Just some cutting comments over here. So say, the next time John gets a four-letter word, Susie, you could say... Oh, you know what? I see another four-letter word, John. Shit! And then the audience all start to chant, crayons, crayons. And then Rachel comes over with a dunce hat and gives him crayons and a colouring book. And then he does that for the next round. That would be an option. Say someone gets an old-fashioned sort of word, like frock or wireless. You could go, hey, you're not on Countdown to Abbey, right? And then it's like, zing, and then you high-five the front row. And, you know, swing your top around above your head, something like that. And then I watch this show a lot, and very often contestants are slightly drably dressed, like the lady in the glasses over there. To have some stock sort of put down lines, so something like, nice word, Joe, but that outfit makes you look like the sort of person who flashes mourners in a pet cemetery. Just simple ways of just livening up the old formula.
Back to me.
Okay. You're not on Countdown to Abbey.
That's one of the best jokes I've ever come up with. That. And what's Jackie Chan's favourite dessert? Creme brulee. They're my two jokes of the year.
Sure. OK, the scores at the end of part three. Sean is on 33, John is on 34. Neck and neck. And here is your teaser. The words are neat knob, and the clue is, comes in different colours and sizes. That's neat knob, and the clue is, comes in different colours and sizes. See you after the break. Hello and welcome back to 8 Out of 10 Cats Does Countdown. The answer to the teaser, the words were neat knob, and the clue was, comes in different colours and sizes.
I know, I know. Banknote.
He's got it.
I saw it earlier, they scrolled it up and then...
OK, time for our final letters game. It's all still to play for. John, your turn to choose.
Oh, you're still here, eh? Hello.
Hello.
Can I have a consonant?
Oh.
This is a problem. Yeah. There we go. Remember what they told me?
Well, I ain't doing it in front of the cameras, will you?
These cameras. Don't you make a scene. What do you want?
Consonant. Foul.
Can we have a consonant, please?
Well considered. G.
And a vowel, please.
A.
And a consonant, please.
L.
Yes.
And another vowel.
E.
There's a four. There's a four. We're stick.
OK, they're sticking.
Do you want a twist? Just see what happens.
Go on, yeah, try. Oh, God. We need an S.
Can we have an S, please?
Shit!
Oh, well, that's not a word, is it?
Oh.
Can we have a vowel, please?
O.
And a consonant.
T.
And another consonant.
R.
And another vowel, please.
And the last one. A.
OK, your time starts now. John, what have you got?
An incredibly risky seven.
A very risky seven. Joe, what have you got?
Well, I find that quite distracting. So I've got a risky four.
Sean, what have you got?
Six.
Clark?
Seven.
Seven. OK, well, let's hear these sevens.
Oh, I've gone for gloater.
Me too.
So you both got gloater. Sean, what did you get? What was your...?
Legate.
That's good.
Mm. One person is legate.
In fact, there's only one E, so you can probably have legates.
Oh, of course, there's only one E.
But you were almost there, Sean.
So what was your risky four out of interest, Joe?
Gail.
OK. Sean now has 40, John has 41. It couldn't be closer as we go into the final numbers game. OK, Sean, go ahead, pick your numbers.
Two from the big. And anything else you think's a good idea.
Just do this.
Go. Concentrate.
Okay. Three. It's all to play for.
Three, one, two, five. And the large two, 25 and 50. And the target, 527.
OK, let's count down. What have you got?
I got... Well, I think we both... I've got 527, sorry. 527.
527, OK, you got that. And John?
528.
Oh! Sean, take me through your working.
2 times 5 is 10.
Yeah.
Times 50 is 500.
Yeah.
25 plus 3 minus 1.
Well done.
Been so patronised in my entire life.
Yes, Sean, he can walk, can't he? Sean, he has a biscuit.
No, thank you. Thank you very much.
Joe, what did you get then?
I didn't even get close, but I'm more really here for eye candy.
Okay. So the scores at the end of that, Sean has 50, John has 41. It's pretty tense in here. It is all to play for. OK, time now for today's crucial countdown conundrum. This is just for Sean and John. Clark, Joe, no helping.
Oh, that's nice, isn't it?
So it's the all-important countdown conundrum. Fingers on buzzers. Here we go. Sean.
She just couldn't help herself. She didn't want it to end. I've had such a brilliant day.
John? OK, Joe?
I just prefer it when it's just in the right order to begin with, so I didn't really join it. I don't know what's happening.
OK, Clark, did you get it?
Is it husbandry?
Oh!
It is, but it doesn't count. But well done. The final scores are Sean has 50, John has 41. And our winner tonight gets this limited edition countdown teapot. Look at that. There you go. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Well done.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you for your help. Thank you, Rachel. I just like to say, John, in your face!
John, anything you'd like to say to Sean?
This is the worst day of my life.
Some people have got it. He's got this brain. It's incredible. It's amazing. Sometimes I surprise myself.
The closer you leave that to me, the greater chance of me shitting in it before. Best.
What wonderful sportsmanship to see there.
Great thing is about your victory, you can really get home and know you did it all yourself. And... no one helped me. I got lumbered with this. No, sense, mate.
I think we're splitting up, mate.
Well, thanks to all our players, our wonderful studio audience, Rachel, Susie, David, all the Romans for our alphabet, all the Arabic Hindu mathematicians for all our numbers, and all of you for watching at home. That's it from us. Good night.
The master of hip-hop, Grandmaster Flash, and R&B collective Soul to Soul take us right through the night with House Party, live from midnight here on 4. Up next, charting the entry of dance music into the mainstream with Idris Elba's How Clubbing Changed the World.